circle your arm around. I want you to really reach. I don't want you to cheat yourself. I don't want little T-Rex arms here. I want really big circles. And hands come back down to the floor. Plank pose, chaturanga. Upward dog, downward dog. Left foot forward, lunge again. Left knee 90 degree angle. Take a peek at that right foot. Right heel straight up to the sky. Opening the bottom of the foot evenly through all five toes. Come up into lunge. Get there. And forward bend. If you meet a lot of resistance with the hamstring, then go ahead and bend the knees. Coming over in the pose. If your hands separate, that means you've rounded your back. And you only want to go as far as you can with a nice flat back. Dive over your arms and kiss the floor if you can. Press it back. Maybe initially you just go this far, not that far at all, until someday you get full range of motion. Take a deep breath in, come up as high as you can. This is generated by the strength in your legs. So the legs go up and press back. A deep breath in. On the exhale, bring your right foot through and you're gonna turn to the left for half side squat. Left toes point up to the sky and then come back up. If that's too hard in the beginning, you could always drop the back knee to the floor like this. And left leg up to the sky, nice and high. Bend the knee, left foot forward between the hands, turning to the right. Same thing as you did on the other side, half side squat. Maybe a little deeper this time. Shift to the back leg. Help your balance. And bring the right foot forward. Press those hips up and feel the IT band. Right deep hip. And breathe. Press the left hand into the floor. Get long. And helps them reduce ankle injuries. Opening up the plantar fascia, which is the bottom tissue of your foot, stretches the Achilles tendon, which is always a problem if you're a runner. Whether you play pro sports or whether you're just a kid, and the calves as well, it opens up. Now hold this. Left leg forward. You could be here, or you could be here on your forearms, or you could be all the way extended. What is important in pigeon is that your hips are square in center and you're not leaning on the left butt. Things about frog is proper alignment. From a side view, my hips are in line with my knees. So I'm not forward and I'm not back. I'm right in line with my hip. Just drop the left knee down and twist like that. Inhale and exhale. First warrior. Left hand comes up to meet the right and then windmill your arms down. Press back to plank pose. Chaturanga. Upward dog. And downward dog. Nice job. Other side. Left foot forward. Right foot flat. Warrior one. Dropping the head back if it feels okay. Stretching out the front of the thigh and the quad. If you feel great, untuck the toes while you're here. Go deeper.